do my first story time. So, yeah. So I'm kind of talking low because the last time I kind of did this with a microphone in my ear, I was kind of yelling at the, I could hear, the audio was going in and out. So today we're going to do a story time over NBA 2K16. And today the story time is going to be about time I almost got robbed. Yes, your boy has been in this ghetto life. I am just playing. But, So one day, we have to do a concert. We have to do these concerts. I'm in the choir. So we had to do this little concert. And so I had got my dad to take me to the barbershop. And so as my dad was taking me to the barbershop, I think he went to the day school. He went to school. So my dad kind of took me to the barbershop. And there's a Wendy's right across the street from the barbershop. It's the Texas Longhorns. Yeah, it's a Wendy's across the street from the barbershop. And so we went to that barbershop. I asked my dad, could I go to Wendy's to take care? So I just took the money and I went to Wendy's.
No doubt about it, Greg. And seeing these players out here tonight, I remember how the love for the game of basketball.
I went to Wendy's and I could win there, right? So
when I was playing,
as I'm going to Wendy's,
invaluable. I mean, the experience you gain with excellent coaching and
mentorship at this level. I didn't notice it at first, but there's this bush right outside. Part of where you go with your talent. So when I walk by there, there's nothing here.
So I'm the four for Texas.
So I go to Wendy's. I order me a 4-for-4, large drink, large fry. Then it's turn, and it's four in at the fourth. So I'll come back from Wendy's.
On the free throw, no good.
As I'm coming back from Wendy's.
The Texas Longhorns been building their basketball program over the years. They've been on the verge of greatness for a long time.
I think Texas in general is very
were in that bush that I walked by and I didn't see anything. So I guess they must have like heard me. I probably was not paying attention. I probably was like listening to my music. So that's the reason why they didn't hear me or see me.
Don't have any college titles.
So in men's basketball, they have as I was saying, going to Wendy's, I didn't see anything. So I'm coming back out and my matter of time. And luck you see is a lot of players not that good, so there's a hobo right there. It's two hobos. And one of them said, he said this quote. He said, run that food in word. And he said, little in word, actually. He said, run that food, little in word. And so as he said that, I kind of got scared. And I was like, I knew what that meant because I watched like the All Together movies. So yeah.
That's as impressive as a skill set.
But yeah, I kind of know what that means. I watch a lot of good movies, but so I kind of took that to heart, and I was like, nah, man. He was like, run that food, and so then he kind of
fires the three.
He said, run that food, and then so I was like, nah, man, I'm sorry, but you know. I got a couple of dollars in here. So he was like, nah, man, I want yours. And I was like, it's not jail, fam. So he kind of
stolen away.
Took my food.
Right outside from deep.
He took my food.
And he gets it to go.
No, he tried to take my food. He pulled out like this sharp stick. Now, I didn't want to die that day, so I kind of got scared. He said, run that food. And the other one started moving closer. So as the other one started moving closer, I was like, oh my God, what am I going to do? So,
following the three-pointer by Freak.
So after he was playing around with it. He was like, run that food. So I had two options in this option. I had the option to give him the food and waste money and be hungry. Or I had the option to take this drink, this large drink, and this big old bag full of food. And I could just run straight to the barbershop, slide in, lock the door, and everything would be cool. That's what I said. I was like, all right, so I decided to do.
Villanova leading by four.
The second option.
Well, who could forget Villanova and their one college title? Come on now.
As I was running to the barbershop,
Cinderella stories ever, one of the greatest upsets.
As I was running to the barbershop,
as an eighth seed, these guys down.
And so I ran and I got a head start. I didn't push or anything. I just ran. I got a head start, but they didn't expect it. It was kind of a surprise. So as I was running,
this is a Hudson.
These guys kind of
good
the guys kind of ran. So the guy, he had ran and he had followed me. So the guy was out of breath quickly, but I wasn't because I was scared. Because I had a stab. I just kind of wanted to go home after my haircut. So, to make a long story short, I ran all the way. And the guy, my barber had saw me running. But he said, when I got into the shop, I opened the door to the shop, and he said, I didn't see two hobos following. So I was like, yeah, those two hobos are following. So, terrific pass. I got my hair cut, right? So as I was going, I told my dad, I was like, Dad, I almost got robbed by these hobos over at Wendy's. So I told him the same exact story that I just told y'all. So I told him the same exact story. And as I was telling him that story, he was like, I'm glad you ran it and get him to school. But next time, fight him. I was like, but I don't want to fight him. I'm not a fighter. I'm a talker. You know? So... Ryan is anyway, in for Villanova. So 2 weeks go by, right? And I got six so yeah, shot 2 weeks go by. Edwards, and I go back to the barbershop to get another haircut. So you know, I had something else. So I had like a photo shoot for Mother's Day.
Well, I think the defense got lucky right there.
2 weeks go by, right?
More of those than he misses when he's got that
and
much
so, crap. So right, yeah, 2 weeks go by, and you know, I haven't told any of my outside family on my mom's side, but.
It's Beal on the wing. There's the feed to right.
Yeah, I haven't told any family on my mom's side. And it's in. So at this point, I go back with my mom, right? And so I see those hobos, but this time, they're actually in the barbershop. So I'm kind of scared. So I go in the barbershop and I sit in the back. I sit in the back and they're in the front. So I sit where no one can see. Like, notice, I had a black hoodie on and everything. So as I'm sitting back there, two hobos. One of them stood up and went to the bathroom. And he saw me. And he smiled with like his yellow teeth. It was so disgusting.
Tell you, there's no substitute for consistency.
At the same time, I was like, no, please, I'm saying. So,
you can stay in control of the game. They'll stay in control.
So they're looking at me, right?
If they simply stay good with their execution of the game plan.
I get hungry again. And I run to go to Wendy's again. I was scared at first. I was like, no, man, just go to Wendy's. You know, go to Wendy's and do it again, right, take off. So, as I was going to Wendy's, they saw me, one of them saw me leave. The one who didn't have the knife saw me leave. So I was walking out, and I got pushed out the door.
Hello, welcome
so as
back.
I was getting pushed out the door,
college basketball
I was, as I was getting
Sports.
Pushed out the door,
and if you're just tuning
the guy,
in, this is Kevin
my barber,
along with
he was like,
hurt. They got themselves a bit of breathing room in the first half, and all they have to do the rest of the way is manage
so,
the lead.
Right.
So after that,
Cooper is out there with Bryant, and it's Ilgauskas in at the four-man position.
She
and for Texas,
to the barbershop. She was
got Edwards.
My
also,
she
Ellis
came
out
there.
There.
And so, like, I texted her not to say it out loud.
In at the four
and so,
and for
my
Villanova,
mom
right,
had got
he's
the
in
text.
At three. Brian is out there with Cooper.
As she
and
got
Beal
the text,
in at the point
it was kind
of position.
Funny. And you see Freak out there. As I was texting her,
sure
she was saying my text out loud. And level, I know it's, like, not nice to call people, like,
so
standards, kind
space.
Of stereotypical.
And with Freak, it's his plethora of moves
so, yeah,
that really
it's
impressed
kind of stereotypical.
Me.
So I didn't want to say hobo out loud. But so I texted my mom, she was some hobo sitting right there. And then, like, out of, like, nowhere, all I heard was, what hobos? What hobos? And then, like, I guess, like, they kind of figured out, like, my mom was talking about them. And, you know, it's not kind of hard to spot me and my mom. We look just alike. So, yeah, so they, I guess they kind of, so then I was like, and she was like, boy, use your words. And then, so they definitely knew it was me at that point. So then, as my mom was just sitting there, I stopped texting her. I'm like, never mind. She's like, no, what are you talking about? I want to know. So then I was like, nothing, mom. So then she's like, she kind of got a sign that I was trying to stop talking. So then after that, she was like, okay, so I'm here to pay for you. And I'm leaving. So
Texas
okay,
trails
so
ball
let me go back to that part. So
they really want to find that
out the door
here.
Yeah, and my barber, right. like, kind of stopped him. So
been
I ran to Wendy's again, right? Got the same exact thing, same exact drink. And so as I was coming back, those hobos were in that same spot. But this time,
Edwards,
I just knew to run, so I just ran away. But this time, actually, I tripped.
Turner's got his
so I was like, well, dang, that's a waste of money. But, you know, at least I ain't getting stabbed. So I was like, you know what? Let's just do this. So I poured the drink out. I threw the fries. I threw the chicken nuggets. I threw the burger all on the ground before I got up. Like I did, I kind of did a barrel, and I threw it on the ground. And this car came by and ran the food over. So as the car had ran the food over, I was like, well, hey, at least they can't get it no more, you know? So as I'm sitting down, I go back in the barbershop. I look behind me. These fools pick up the fries, the chicken nuggets. They even pick up the burger. And I see them, like, splitting it in half. And I'm like, oh, my goodness. They
Villanova did not do that.
It was so nasty. Oh, it was so nasty because, like, I was like, how? Why would they do something like that? That is disgusting.
And his family cheers
and
him on from Harlem.
And, Greg, you can see it in this game.
So I was like, no, why would they do
that?
That's disgusting. So they kind of just ate it.
He doesn't take anything for granted.
They
kind of
ate it. And I guess they had to.
Projects like Freak. And he takes pride in playing for Harlem when he's on the court.
And as they were eating it, I was like, oh,
we got Ellis, and it's Rush
in
a
threesome. So then I found out, hey, maybe it's like not all the time.
And the ball goes out of bounds.
Maybe if I would have shared it with him, you know, I probably would have got another good deed. You ever heard that saying, do a good deed? You know, something, I don't know. So yeah, that probably could have happened to me in that instance. But at the same time, I kind of didn't think about that. I was like, no, it's mine.
It's tipped.
Yeah, that's what I kind of was thinking. Yeah, I was like, no, it's mine. So that's how I was thinking in that moment.
And Miller with the ball. And he gets it back. Second chance shot, and Wright pulls
it down. So I was on my way to go back to the barbershop, I kind of realized, you know, hey, maybe, you know, he gave
the line to shoot two.
So
talk about some great numbers.
Let's say
15 points.
3 days go by.
And
the barbershop is more for like places just like the barbershop. It's kind
of
like a place where like everyone can go and like hang out.
Savvy
so turns out it's
and
my
look at how the
barber's
sister's
birthday. So they like grill out at the barbershop.
Effort from a
so we're at the cookout.
And
it turns out my barber actually knew the fools who tried to take my food.
Has been the amount of points they scored off time.
I was like, he was talking to me offline, you know, kind of off to the side. You know, we're just talking. You know, we're drinking, not like lean or not liquor. We're drinking sodas. So yeah, we kind
of
were just, you know, sitting over there having a good time, you know.
You know,
I was drinking a soda and a red cup. Probably drinking something else. But
he's an amazing student off the floor.
But
he's very dedicated.
I'm like, hey, you know those guys that sit right there? You know, like those guys in the jeans and boots and the hats. It's like, yeah, man, what about them? I'm like, you know they tried to rob me for some food, right? He was like, they ain't trying to rob you for the food. I was like, hold on. He was like, so you know that one week I came here to get that little fade or whatever? He was like, yeah, we got the Wendy's, right? I was like, yeah, so you know you saw me like running in to open the door, right? Because I was running. So he was like, oh, yeah, I seen that. So then I was like, all right, so basically those are the dudes who tried to rob me. That's why I was running. He said, you ain't seen no hobo.
Because
he's like, yeah, I did. He's like, okay. So look, I need
now,
you to
here's Blake.
You know,
defense
you,
right
you
on
do
him.
Yourself, you know what I'm saying? That's how I met
Warwick
them too.
The
they
bucket.
Actually robbed me though, because you know, I'm old. I can't be chasing down fools. You
43
know
seconds left in
so,
the second half of basketball.
He said, I said, all right, man, it's whatever. And then he's like, yeah, so I go over there, right?
Close, Kevin,
in the most uncomfortable
the
position I have ever been in my life. I'm actually introducing
there
myself to a hobo. So,
as lucky next time down
so as I'm
defense,
in, I'm like, yo, I'm X. He was like, it was like, oh, yeah, that's cool. It was like, oh, yeah, man, we know you. He was like, yeah. I'm like, yeah, y'all the dude, y'all tried to rock.
There's
y'all
18
remember
seconds
that?
Left
so then
to play
he was
here
like,
in the second half.
Yeah, that's how we know this. So
no,
that's how we met Paul. And I was like, he give us free cuts, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, he broke off some of his, he just ran. I was like, oh, yeah, so, you know, we kind of had laughs, you know. They told me, like, you know, what all adults tell you, stay in school, get a good education, so, you know, be in this point right here where they at right now. So I was like, all right, man, you know, good advice, yo. So my dad is there, you know, so, you know, we go home, and, you know, I kind of think about the advice, and I'm like, yeah, man, I might not, you know. So we have spring formal, right? Spring formal is basically
Rush
like spring formal. It's a dance.
And that
so spring
good.
Formal is coming up. And
5 seconds left in the second half of basketball.
So, yeah, so, like, my dad, he takes me back to the barbershop. And so, he's like, so, his name is Terry. Terry came out of the bushes, and he's like, hey, what's up, young man? I was like, oh, how you doing, Mr. Terry? He's like, you want to come back here? He's like, today we got a home. We're going to need to rob you. And I was like, not funny. But at the same time, it was kind of interesting. So, I went back to where, like, you know, they kind of live, I guess you could say. And we kind of had a laugh or two, you know. And, you know, so as I went back there, they had beds made out of grass. And I was like, are you freaking serious? Are you freaking serious? So I was like, okay, so anyway, so, you know, it's a bed made out of grass. Oh, well. So same time, though, I'm like, oh, man, what did I do? So... so they were kind of like, okay, so yeah, this is what you get, you know what I'm saying? It's what you get when you don't do your work in school. You know, I used to slack off, you know, want to talk to girls, you know, I put these girls from school work. I failed English in my sophomore year. I was like, how old are you? I was like, this was like a couple years ago. So I was like, I'm 12, and then so yeah, I was 12 in seventh grade. So he was like, yeah, I'm 12. So I was like, yeah, all right, man, yeah, you 12. You know, you really think you know it starts in high school. You know, it starts in college. Nah, man, it starts now. You need to get the education you need. So you know, I was like, yeah, all right, you know me. Went in one ear, out the other. Kind of didn't listen. Cause I think I got in trouble like the next day at school for doing something stupid at the farm. Anyway. Yeah, I did get in trouble for doing something stupid. I'd probably do that in another story time.
Pleasure to have you join us here tonight.
Right now, I got robbed. I almost got robbed.
And we are right in the midst of all the action.
As I,
this is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony.
So as I, I went back to the barbershop. I was like, hey, man, I've been back there with Terry. You know, have you been back there with Terry? He's like, nah, man, I ain't been back there with Terry, man. Terry crazy, man. You know, I know Terry's from the ghetto. That's the only reason he tried to rob me. He was like, man, how you know Terry? So my barber had told me Terry was a rapist. I was like, I wish I had my face cam on so y'all could see my face. But he was like, yeah, man, Terry was just a rapist. You had this incident.
Ryan is out there with Cooper.
You know, we went to Memphis back in, like, at the four-man position. 82. I was like, not funny. So then he was like, he's like, so Terry caught a case of sexual charges. I was like, really? He was like, yeah. I was like, was he taking kids? He was like, nah, man, it was just one girl. You know, it kind of threw him all off. He was like, yeah, man, but Terry was
and
smart.
That one misses.
He had, he was taking AP and honor classes.
Going over, they've had a lot of their graduates make waves in the NBA.
You
can find a Wildcat playing professional
ball
everywhere, it seems.
So
yeah,
I was
some
like,
of the current Wildcats
in
the NBA,
you know?
Kyle Lowry,
he's
had a terrific career thus far. Randy Foy are the big names. Dante Cunningham's another guy who's had an impact.
We just played this game, you know. Whoever got best, I'm going to say, whoever could, like, smash first. So, Terry wanted to prove his coolness. So, he went and got this girl that said no to him. And he basically, sexually assaulted her. So, now he's living on the streets. He did, like, Barber said he did 15 in jail. I was like, oh, that's good.
They set the
pick. Like,
and
like,
why
did I almost say, oh, that's good? Like doing 15 years in jail is something to be proud of. But anyway, he was like, yeah, man, he did 15 in jail. I was like,
man,
he did 15 in the pen. So then he was like, yeah, man, he did 15. So then I was like, heck no.
Lays it up and
then I was like, that's the story of Terry.
Beal, the
pass to Wright. That's not kind of cool, you know. In the news, you hear like a lot of women.
Outside Bryant. And Beal gets to Wright. And the layup is good after a nice rebound.
Wright's
got six.
So, you know, they've scored several times already here in the first quarter down low. I like
that.
Right.
So, it's
like
yeah.
a running game
but
in football.
But Terry is actually a cool dude, you know.
Inside. It also allows you to control the team's
lesson,
transition.
You know, not to stick at the wrong crowd. So, the moral of several story. Oh,
and stolen by Trice.
But the moral of that story is, you know, make decisions now.
Master Randolph.
You know, don't
unloads
wait
from 13.
Show.
And that one goes
moral off. Of the other story.
I'll tell you what,
be,
for
you
what's
know,
really
don't a, hang out with the wrong crowd.
An elementary shot. He looked a little nervous on that release.
Yeah.
Wright, the pass to Cooper. And Bryant kicks to Wright. Out left to the wing. Here's Ilgauskas.
So, oh,
he's holding by the
right
Hoyas.
So
you're not going to see that very often. Plenty
so
of
anyway.
Space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that.
So, I went home.
They
like,
need a good offensive
night,
possession.
Yeah, they've
video.
Had a number of empties
so,
a long time without
I'm playing video games. I get an Amber Alert on my phone.
What are you going to do
to not like, y'all know if y'all get Amber
Alert.
The Amber Alert.
In that matchup.
So, I was like, dang. He said, our area, you know, let me stay in the house. So, like I said, the barbershop, you don't have to necessarily get a cut. I guess I'm always in the barbershop. So, yeah, so I went back to the barbershop. And for some reason, Terry wasn't there. I was like, hey, call where Terry? He was like, so, you know that Amber Alert that popped up yesterday? I was like, yeah, it showed up on my phone at like 11 a.m.
trails by
night.
Three.
He's
so
like, yeah,
on
man,
the floor
Jerry,
for Villanova,
he,
right, he's in a small
he convinced
fold.
A man to get
Cooper
him some
is out there
Allison,
and it's Beal
you know,
into
liquor or whatever.
And if the shot's
and
not there,
he was like,
you've
I was
got
like,
to
really?
Understand
and
that
he was like,
the basketball.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
He,
and I'm not quite sure what his mindset or what he was thinking
went
there. I mean,
went berserk. He kind of went back to his old ways. So the coincidence is like
has been
Terry
such a
raped another woman, and like I think
so
Terry is
really one of the
still in jail. I think.
On the East Coast.
Yeah,
the
you guy, know that's exactly right. A really rich tradition in men's basketball
defender,
for the Hoyas,
yeah.
And they've been a competitive
know the
presence
court
on the
system
college
in
basketball
and out.
Landscape going back to the
70s. Know the, yeah, I don't know the system.
And
it's
right
not like
missing.
That, but you know, strike two. You know, be
Randolph
careful.
Against Foster.
So yeah, I know he got jail time though, because he ain't been at the barbershop lately. So yeah.
Now here's Wright. 8 points for him.
Yeah, so he basically just
pulls up on the way.
Jail time.
It's
still in jail today.
5 for 6 on the game.
But at the same time,
and for the Hoyas,
I'm not surprised he ain't in jail. He tried to rob me, and he tried to rob my barber.
In the Washington D.C. area,
yeah, so
it's
clearly something missing
wrong
with
him.
It's
not
really mentally,
just
but, you know, there's something there, you can tell.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
You know, hey. You run into some strange people. You learn a lot of things.
Randolph up top,
game.
Covered by Ilgauskas. Randolph kicks to Hudson. That's good.
So,
The Hoyas only have one college tournament title in their history. They
so,
won it all
yeah, so,
in 1984 and then returned in 85 to the title game. Only to be upset by Villanova.
8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Beal gets a wide open look. Off the mark there with the 3 point shot.
So, basically, you learn something new every day. You know, I
and
learned something for like a month from Terry. But Terry was cool, man. You could tell. You could tell he was smart, though, because, like, the way he talked and stuff, like, it was like, yes, sir. You know, he said,
to the left side
sir.
Wing.
You know, he kind of. You ever watch Beyond Scared Straight?
I tell you what,
kid,
I bet he won't miss
there,
that
like,
shot next time.
Dick things, like,
and a pretty tight and contested game here as we end the
so,
first half.
I guess he didn't
Villanova
do that.
On top.
I guess. I don't know,
up by one. And stay with us, folks.
So, yeah,
we'll be back
but
just
you
after
can
halftime
tell
to get
like
the second
smart.
Half of College Hoops underway.
I don't end up like that, you know, waking up one day saying, I could have did anything in my life. You know, now I'm in jail, you know, for, you know, trying to rape a chick. College. Oh man, if you really think about it, it weighs heavy. My knee popped. Hold on, y'all. Ooh, ease on out of there, baby. Ease on out. Ease on out. Ease on out. Ease on out. Ease on out.
And the second
I'm sorry,
half of basketball
okay, I should
is about to get underway, folks. Welcome back to this broadcast of college basketball. here on 2K Sports.
Oh, yeah. Good way to straighten that out. So,
guys, you know, it's been a close one thus far. Both teams have had strong stretches. Neither team has really been able to take control of the game to this point.
Kind of procrastinating
guys,
now.
It's kind of like a boxing match.
My team really did like us, so I'm probably just going to finish this game.
Half,
and that's going to be the end of the broadcast.
Up,
so,
let's
kind of talk, small talk. So,
Hudson is up there with
Warren. One of these days,
that's Trice. Then there's Price. And it's Randolph.
Might not have a gameplay. So my sister's birthday was yesterday.
And out there with Cooper. And
ooh, look at that shot. But so yeah, I'm probably not gonna have a good broadcast.
That's Trice.
Early in the day.
Villanova shooting their first free throws.
You know what I mean? Yeah, early in the day. In the morning, you know, it's Saturday. Pretty much don't have nothing to do. But my sister's birthday party is today. So maybe, you know, one day I might do a broadcast late Saturday night. So it's definitely going to be one tomorrow. Most def. Twilight of Quali, I'm playing. But yeah, it's most definitely going to be a gameplay tomorrow. So,
He's a dead eye at the line, fellas. Just call him
Yeah, it's going to be most definitely going to be a gameplay.
Well, there have been a lot of great players out of Georgetown over the years. Gotta go to detention now. Shut down D, but that shouldn't make anything. Gameplay might come earlier.
But at the same time, Saturday, there might be one, there might not be one, so tune in, you know? Tune in,
and Beal gets to Bryant. Ogauskas a screen on Price.
Boom. Wow, I was going to get that. Right, but anyway, so yeah, tune in. You know, you never know.
Make it count.
I might make a
nice
movie.
Job of
but so tomorrow, I'll have to ask. I'm probably going to play. I want to play a game that I haven't played before. I haven't played this game yet. And if I play it, the only person I'm going to play it with is someone special.
He's changing it up here. Here's Beal.
So, yeah. I'm not going
to
play it by myself.
Right,
it's not fun by
Ogauskas
myself.
Ogauskas a screen on Price. There's
Beal
with
shoot
the
that.
Three. Good.
But yeah, so tomorrow I'm probably going to play a certain game
screen, but still
that
as a defender,
only, you know, I know what I'm talking about.
Over and through that.
So,
the D,
on the floor for Villanova.
About the
Price, he's in
a
three. Cooper is out there with McAdoo, and it's Ogauskas in at the four. Right from
shot.
Outside. Joseph
oh,
Whitney.
Man, what is my field goal, dude? I'm going 5 for 10.
The rebound.
12 points. Your boy is doing
first down trails by 5.
All right, so, yeah, so tomorrow, it's only a game that I play with
Spurs. Moving the ball around.
And
the
you got to be special
Randolph.
To play this game.
Again,
at the same time, all my data is on my other
Randolph
PlayStation.
Gone 2 for 4
you know
so
ooh,
far here
ba, 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 ba.
To the inside. And
you suck. Anyway, so, yeah, my data is
here's
all
Price.
On my other PlayStation. So
outside Randolph.
I might have to do it. I have to pull some off tomorrow.
You know, even though he missed that three-point shot, I think the defense
sneaky,
has to do a better job of challenging
to my life.
The shot.
Just kidding, guys.
As a coach, you can really ill afford to have those types
just
of
kidding, guys. I'm probably
going
to bring my
defense.
PlayStation to my locker. Probably going to switch out systems. No biggie.
Tries with it.
Also,
the Price. Hudson kicks to Price. Fires from 14. Randolph can't get that one to fall. Villanova leading by 3.
So I'm probably going
to.
This is
it to McAdoo.
Ooh,
goes to the
that was a good shot. So, yeah, so I'll probably have
overpower
to
you at
make
the rim,
some moves,
but he
sneak
likes
my
to
PlayStation
elude you
into my locker.
And trick you. He's got quickness and assault time.
Also, base cam might not be available for a couple of days. So just know that base cam might not be there. But. If it is, good. If it's not, oh well. It's my first video without my face cam. I'm kind of missing my baby. I can't see my beautiful face.
I
got like taco
sauce
on my
hoodie. Ryan's checked
in.
I
went to Lowe's today. It was Cinco de Mayo. Oh yeah, by the way, happy Cinco de Mayo to all my, I don't want to say Mexican, Hispanic viewers.
Left to play here in the second half.
Yeah, my Hispanic viewers.
Here's Price. So the whistle blows. So, Cinco de Mayo. Right there.
Yeah. Really, the right play.
Hopefully, you don't get too drunk if you're old enough. If you're watching me right now.
Yeah, exactly. So
but,
give him a little bump. And
yeah, just everything is everything. So, hopefully, that's not good.
Into the lane next time. And if they don't think about it, at least they might be distracted.
What else? What else? What else?
That one miss was huge. He had a chance to turn this into a one possession game.
Sunday.
Right outside.
Oh, I forgot. So, Sunday. Okay, see, I know that game Zombie I did. So, Zombie, I kind of didn't finish that. It was kind of late that night. So, and I had school night. So, I had to kind of go home. So, yeah. So, I'm probably going to finish that game plan.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert.
Ooh, good three.
Very often.
Exactly. All right, I need to get some points, though. Like, I'm going 5 for 13.
Now, the Hoyas with it.
So, they're probably not going to give me ball. So, we need to.
Dinesh DeWarren. Fader
so,
on the way.
So, that story time is over. So, let's get back to regular game commentary. So, what's up, guys? I'm playing. It's story time.
And he commits the intentional
foul. They could have passed it to me. I would have hit. All right, so don't jack it. Make the safe pass. That's all I know right now. But, yeah, so my story is over. So, you know, like it or hate it, but
there's
it's over.
25 seconds left in the second half of
so,
basketball.
Yeah.
And now they
why do I have
to
pass it in? I should be scoring. All right, yeah. So.
24 seconds left in the second half. Three-pointer right.
Damn. I'm playing. It's their ball.
Now the Hoyas
with it.
Play
a tight D.
Trailing by two. Now Trice.
Come on, guys. Maximum effort.
He hits it to Warren.
Yeah. Oh, they're trying to put it away.
To tie it up. Oh, missed it. Right. Can't connect.
So why do you be looking so good? So like I'm about to make it. He had to
they
overthrow it. So yeah, guys. That's probably gonna do it for today. Thursday, Cinco de Mayo. Happy day. Like I said, tomorrow for sure broadcast Friday. Other than that, I love you guys. Subscribe, like. Do anything you can to make my channel better. Please, I need you guys. Just please, I need you guys. Like, honestly, I need you guys. But anyway, so, like I said, like, subscribe, do all you can, you know? Do all you can. I'm kind of going to get deep with y'all here. Don't forget, guys. Talent fails. Hard work beats talent when talent fails to work hard. I don't know. Good job, though, guys. Subscribe, like, do anything. I'm in need. But, yeah. I'm stalling. Bye, guys.